Hi, this is Matt with 2A Direct, and today we're going to go over a few additional features that you can set on your VX231 handhelds. And these are the most popular ones that we come across with our customers here at 2A Direct, so we're going to go ahead and focus on a few of these. So we have here a sample archive, and just going down the line here, we have our list of channels 1 through 16. And in this column here, we can set a priority. We'll touch on this in a moment when we go over the scan feature. But most typically, we like to set channel 1 as that priority, but we'll touch on that a little bit later. This column here is where you can select wide or narrow band, 25 or 12.5 kilohertz. And all new radios per the FCC mandate automatically, you can see, are set to narrow band. Next columns here, we have the receive and transmit frequency. As you can see, these are all just simplex. If we had a repeater, obviously these would be different, but right now they're set to simplex. And next column here, we have the sub audio tones. And basically, these are inputted by double clicking. And you can select from this chart here. And you always want to make sure that when you're inputting these, especially for any of these ones here, which are called CTCCS tones. These are going to make that static sound at the end of a transmission unless we change a particular setting. So what you're going to want to do anytime you use this tone here, any of these tones here, so just think if it's a decimal, you're going to have to do this specific setting up here to eliminate that squelch tail at the end of the transmission. So you're going to want to go to the Miscellaneous tab here under Common, and then under the CTCSS tail elimination. You can see it's disabled. We need to change this to a 180. Basically, what this means in a nutshell is it's just going to cut off that squelch tail at the end of the transmission, so you're not going to hear that, and you're not going to damage everyone's eardrums shooting back that static. So now that that's been changed, we'll no longer do that. And then there's a couple other settings under Common that we like to do for our customers, and we're going to show you those right now. Power saving here. In our last video, we showed you that we like to turn this to 1:1, but if you're concerned about your radio's battery life, you can go all the way down here to a 1:1:4, which means basically that your radio is going to go into an idle mode if it's been sitting for a few minutes, and that's going to save and conserve battery life. But the drawback to this is if you're getting a transmission from someone, it might cut the first tenth to half a second off of that transmission. So if your radio transmissions are really important, you probably want to stick at a 1:1 or even an ABS so it doesn't go into that idle mode. Now, other than that, down here under mic gain, if you work in a noisy environment, you can change the gain to a plus 6 dB. It's just going to make your microphone a lot louder. It's going to make the speaker a lot louder on your radio, rather. Any audio accessory you plug in there, it's also going to put out more audio output. Downside to this, obviously, you're going to drain your battery life a little bit quicker. So, typically, only recommend this for very loud working environments. And also, if you have the high capacity battery, that's probably a better one to have if you're going to use the higher sound level here. And just going down the line here, scanning is a very popular feature that we do for a good majority of our customers here at 2A Direct. So what we want to do here is just set a few settings for scan. So basically, going down the line here, scan resume time. So basically, if we pick up a scan channel, it's going to resume after 2 seconds if nothing's happening there. And there's also an option for a second one if you want to have two different settings for two different scan lists. But these here usually remain at the default. Priority check. You can enable or disable this, and this is going back to our priority channel one over here that we set. So typically, this is going to be enabled, and then priority check interval. This is always left at a 2 second for the most part. Just causes less delays in getting back in the regular radio traffic. Now going under the talkback feature here, very important feature. A lot of people like to have this enabled. Simply by clicking the drop down, you can enable this. What this means is, let's say you and I are communicating on channel 1, and I pick up engineering department on channel 5, let's say, because I'm scanning and that's an active channel. With the enabled feature, I can answer them back without changing the channel selector at the top of the radio. If I didn't have this talkback enabled, I would manually have to crank the channel selector over to channel 5 here to communicate with them. So for most busy people, they like to just have that enabled so they can just answer the person back right away. And then it's going to revert back after a few channels, and revert channel, it's going to go back to our priority, which is channel 1. Scan beep, we almost always turn this off because no one wants to hear a beep in their earpiece or in their shoulder microphone when they're activating scan. So almost always disable that, unless you're really worried about hitting scan on accident, then you might want to have that available. And remember, any changes you make here, you always have to hit apply first and then OK, or else they're not going to lock those in. So always make sure you do that. Some other features here, you can go ahead and lock the radio with a few different areas here. Typically don't have a lot of use for this unless someone's wearing a radio on their hip and it's getting banged around a lot. You might want to select some of these just to lock up your radio, but typically not a very common feature that we set for our customers. Next is key functionality. This is very important. You'll notice on the side of your 231 there are two option buttons underneath the push talk button. And as a standard, they come set in this manner. Side button 1 is set to monitor. But as you can see, there's an array of choices here. And just going down the line, we won't have time to touch on all these today, but we have monitor, setting the squelch, low power, and of course, scan, FM scan, setting scan, DW, talk around scan, talk around, transmit, save, disable, resetting the radio, doing an MDC call, speed dialing, lock, and some more paging functionality. But scan is also that one, that very popular feature that we're going to have to set one of these option buttons to activate. Everything we did earlier, it's not going to work unless we can actually program one of these option buttons to set that. So most popular is usually just a quick press on side 1, but if you're concerned about hitting that button on accident, you can always do a press and hold here, and you can actually set the amount of time that you want to have to hold down that button to activate any of these functions. So if you think you might hit that button on accident, you might want to set the time frame which you have to hold down the button to a few seconds, just so it doesn't get hit on accident. So that's very important, and those are some of the key features that we set on the radio. And remember, any changes you need to hit apply and then OK that. And then from there, we can see that this column over here is for the scan. So right now, scan is set on every channel. So we have that option button 1 set to activate the scan. And now we're going to scan all 16 channels. And you can see here our priority is still channel 1. But if you want to change that to any other channel, it would just be a matter of double clicking down here. And just to go on to a few other columns here really quick, power saving on the transmit or receive, you can drop that down to a watt of power. If you're in a close radius with the other radio users, you might be able to drop that down and save some battery life. So that's done in this manner right here, just double clicking in this column. As well as we have high and low power over here. So if we can drop that down to low power for transmit and receive. So it's going to cut it from 5 watts down to 1 watt of power. But I only recommend that for users that are in close proximity so you can still get full coverage with your radios. Other than that, last really popular feature that we're going to touch on is just the squelch setting here. As we can see, it comes with a default of 4, but you can always loosen that up. It goes all the way up to 15 and obviously down to a squelch of 0. I recommend leaving it at 4 unless you want to experience a little bit more static, or if you want to have a little bit less coverage area. But squelch level 4 is usually the best one to have the radio set to. So those are a few key features of the 231s that we normally set up. In our next video, we'll touch on a few more, but that's all from 2-Way Direct right now. Thank you very much.